Human anatomy. Lungs. Humans need a continuous supply of oxygen for respiration. Humans take in oxygen and leave out carbon dioxide, which is the poisonous waste product in the process of respiration. The lungs are an essential respiratory organ in the human body. The human anatomy consists of two lungs. They can be called as the left and right lung, respectively. The left lung has two lobes, while the right lung has three lobes. The lungs contain approximately 1,500 miles of airways and about 300 to 500 million alveoli. The total surface area is approximately 70 square meters in a fully grown human body, roughly the size of a badminton court. An alveoli, also known as little cavity, is derived from the Latin word alveolus, and these are the terminal ends of the respiratory tree and are shaped like a hollow cavity. The average respiratory rates of a resting adult is about 10 to 20 breaths per minute. This means that we spend about one-third of a minute inhaling. The total breathing capacity, however, depends on the individual. That is, it carries on factors depending on age, height, weight, and sex. It's observed that females tend to have 20 to 25% lower breathing capacity than males, while tall people tend to have larger lung capacity than short people. People living in low-lined areas, or at sea level, tend to have smaller lung capacity than those people living at a higher altitude. People who smoke have a lower lung capacity than non-smokers. Lungs function similar to that of bellows, which is a mechanical device that blows strong current of air. Lungs convert the hormones that cause the narrowing of blood vessels and drives the blood pressure up, and also removes the waste products in the blood. The lungs are covered by a structure known as the pulmonary pleura. The lung is an important organ that performs various functions that happen every second of our lives, out of which breathing is considered to be the most essential. As previously mentioned, the lungs take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. The air that we breathe in enters the human body and reaches the lungs through a windpipe called the trachea, which branches further into two main tubes which distributes the air supply to both the left and the right lung, respectively. These tubes further divide themselves into 22 times to the number of branches, resulting in the formation of more than 100,000 smaller tubes, called bronchioles, and about 300 million air sacs, or alveoli, which are only about 0.3 millimeters in diameter. Since the walls of an alveoli are 1/50th the thickness of a tissue paper and are also covered up with millions of tiny blood vessels called capillaries, there is a free flow exchange of both oxygen and carbon dioxide between the body and the environment. The lungs play an important role in the body's defense against infection and other harmful environmental factors. Air inhaled either through the nose or the mouth may consist of various dust particles or infectious agents, and end up getting stored in the lungs. Mucus, which is a sticky liquid that is produced by the lungs, may trap the inhaled particles, while the lungs' white blood cells, that serve as protective agents, aid in the engulfment and destruction of such harmful matter and bacteria. So, one good alternative is to cough. Coughing helps clear the mucus and other materials from the